Hello, and today we are with Miss Kati Hakkinen, who is owner of a hotel in a luxurious hotel in Khanom, Thailand. Good afternoon to you, Kati.
Hello, how are you?
Very well, thank you. Now, first of all, let's talk about where your property is, because a lot of people may not know Khanom. Where is Khanom in Thailand?
So Khanom is in southern Thailand. We are on the east coast, facing Koh Samui. So we are on the Gulf of Siam side. About 1 hour drive from Surat Thani and 1 hour drive from Nakhon Si Thammarat cities. And it's actually Nakhon Si Thammarat province where we are.
Why is there a resort there?
Because there's absolutely nothing there. We were actually backpacking 11 years ago with my partner, and we accidentally found this place, Khanom. Totally fell in love to the place. It was the most beautiful beaches we've ever seen, and locals who smiled from their heart, and it was just love on a first sight.
Now, you are selling a beach destination. Tell me about the beaches. What is it that's special about the water quality and the beaches in Khanom, where your property is?
So the beach is actually our biggest selling point. It's absolutely gorgeous white sandy beach. It's not rough sand like on Khao Lak or Phuket side. Gorgeous white sand and turquoise water. And our season is 10 and a half months. We don't have rainy season like on west coast, but we do have then monsoon season on November, December time.
So November, December time, is that your low season traditionally?
Weather-wisely that would be our low season.
Okay, yeah. Now tell us about the property, because is it Ava? How do you pronounce your property? It's AAVA for those that aren't looking.
Yes.
How do you pronounce that, and where exactly is the property within that area?
Okay, so Ava, first of all, Ava is a Finnish word. We owners are from Finland, and it means open and spacious, calm, all these beautiful, relaxing words together. We are located directly middle of Nadan Beach. Nadan Beach is 9 kilometers long, and we see Koh Samui from our beach.
What is there to do there?
We have, even though Khanom is quiet and unknown destination, not mass tourism destination at all, we have a lot of things to do. For example, pink dolphins. Our main attraction with the beach is pink dolphins who live on our seas. We have beautiful caves, waterfalls. It's a very natural place. But also what people or our customers like to do, they rent a scooter and drive around searching for even more quieter, smaller beaches than what Nadan is already.
Now, I've heard a few hotels say there's whales, there's this, there's that. Pink dolphins is a new one for me. Is the pink dolphins, are they year-round, and how do you get to see them?
We actually can see them. Quite often we see them in front of our resort on a sea, but we do our own tours. We go to see them with local fishing long-tail boats.
Now, if a guest, tell us about the property, this Ava. How many rooms do you have, and how have you broken down the different room categories at the resort?
So we are quite small. We are boutique, 28 bungalows and villas, 4 different room types, from deluxe all the way to family villa. So it's family villa is suitable for families. Two deluxe bungalows together are suitable for families also, and poolside villas, which are very romantic for honeymooners or couples.
Where are your guests coming from at the moment? Which nationalities? What are your top 5 markets?
Okay, so Scandinavia is of course our home. We are very strong in Finland, Denmark and Norway. Surprisingly, domestic market is very big for us. It brings 30% of our revenue. And also traditional markets like Holland or Germany, Netherlands and UK.
Which markets are you trying to increase business from? Where are you targeting the most for this year and next?
Now we are targeting Southern European, like Italy, Spain and France.
Why are you going so far afield when a lot of new resorts, a lot of new destinations tend to aim at the expats in the regional market first before they go to the long haul market?
We try to think about the holiday seasons, because now we are already well sold from January or from December until March and then July, August. So now we are trying to fill up the remaining months. and that's why targeting to these countries now.
What is the average length of stay at the property?
Well, the thing is funny because Thai domestic is very big market for us. They tend to stay one or two nights, but then we have Scandinavians who stay 2 weeks. So average is actually 5 to 6 nights.
Now, a lot of new destinations use sports to attract. Diving is obviously going to be a big attraction in the area. What type of diving is available from departing from your resort?
We don't have diving on our side at all. The sea is totally, the bottom is sandy. There's not much things to see. Maybe 8-9 years ago, some artificial diving spots were set to the sea, but they haven't grown yet. They are not that big yet to really go to sea, so we don't have diving at the moment.
Do you have excursions, for example, island hopping or
yes,
going out to sea? What sort of things are available in that sense?
Well, one very popular tour is, of course, the sea tour. Go to snorkeling. There are beautiful small islands close by Koh Samui, and we take, for example, our customers to dive or snorkeling on that area.
Now, here we are. We're at the Thailand Travel Mart 2019. TAT is trying to promote itself, to promote the emerging destinations, as it calls it, within Thailand. Why are you one of the few, very few actually, places of those emerging places here? Why is it you think, why is there not more from the emerging destinations here?
Oh, I think it's just that there's not enough brave people to do something crazy. It's always a little bit scary to be the first one and start something in a place that is not yet known. For example, when we started to build 10 years ago, lots of people were asking from us, why do you want to build in a destination where there's nothing? And most of the people couldn't see that is our key factor, that is our selling point, that there is not yet anything. And now slowly, Thai people and TAT also has started to see that, okay, European customers, traditional markets, they really are looking for something new, something where neighbor has not yet been.
Now, of course, you will have seen Koh Samui possibly 20 years ago. Somebody might have even said that to me 20 years ago in Koh Samui, that it was still quite new territory.
Yes.
How do you think the provincial government of Nakhon Si Thammarat needs to control tourism so that Khanom doesn't become another mass tourism destination?
This is something that I'm actually very happy to see, that local municipality, local influencers, we all share the idea that Khanom needs to develop sustainably. We are really talking about environmental issues, and all the building laws, they are really taking seriously. So this is us entrepreneurs, hotel owners, and local municipality and governor, on a governor level, for example, we are thinking exactly the same. We want Khanom to develop sustainably.
For the TTM, it's still early, it's still the first day. How has it gone for you so far, and what are you expecting to get from the show?
Okay, so we've been here every single year since we started business, so this is our ninth TTM. We've always had very busy schedule, and we have busy schedule now also. Already the first visits or first meetings that we've had, it has been very nice feedback. Mostly it's just meeting the partners who we already work with, and then some new agencies.
Obviously the TTM Plus is growing, it's improving every year. What are some improvements you'd like to see in the years to come?
Well, maybe in 5-6 year time, I would like to see TTM organized in Khanom.
Is there a lot of hotel development, is there a big pipeline, hotel development pipeline in Khanom?
Yes, actually development is happening. We are now, this year, there's maybe 3-4 quality resorts opening in our area, and it's very positive news for us, because then we have someone to work together and really attract major or bigger travel agencies from Europe.
Now, of course, some of the destinations like Phuket and Koh Samui, even though they are very overdeveloped in a sense, there are things to do, there's places to go. Are there local restaurants and bars,
yes,
to go and enjoy while you're at your hotel?
Yes, actually now in last maybe half a year, there's a lot of very stylish bars and restaurants opened, even on walking distance from our resort.
Excellent. And in terms of that, do you have any plans for any future properties or even an expansion of this property?
Yeah, we do have plans.
And what are they?
Well, we would like to expand. We would like to expand our existing resort.
In what way? More rooms or?
More rooms.
So how many more rooms would you like to see at the property?
Money-wisely thinking, it should be around 80 rooms. It still should be boutique size, but then 80 rooms to really attract bigger travel agencies.
An additional 80?
Yes.
So up to 100 and take you to 108, if my mathematics aren't too wrong this morning.
You actually know totally to be in 80 rooms.
Total 80 rooms.
Yes, and when so more 60 rooms more.
Okay, and when are you hoping to start the construction on that?
When we first find the money.
Yeah, there's always that problem. I have that problem quite a lot. Do you have a guess, like in terms of time frame that you're looking for, would you like that to be completed within the next 2 years, 5 years?
Yeah, next 2 years would
the
be
next
perfect.
2 years.
Yeah.
Excellent, sounds very exciting. Will you be expanding the F&B outlets as well? And what F&B outlets are there at the resort at the moment?
At the moment, we've got two restaurants. We've got a la carte restaurant on a beach side, and then we've got pizzeria on a roadside. And then in expansion, we would have one beach club more.
Beach clubs are very popular. What makes you want to go for a beach club?
Well, it's funky and stylish.
It is. They're a lot of fun and they are very trendy at the moment as
exactly.
Well. Excellent. Well, I look forward to seeing that beach club in a couple of years' time, Kati. Thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and the Aava in Khanom the best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you.